Good evening, and welcome to our parishioners and visitors on the Ascension Sunday. Today is the Feast of the Ascension of the Lord. In other words, we celebrate Jesus' return to the Father's house. But does this mean that today we celebrate the end of Jesus' presence here on earth? No, this is not the end of Jesus' presence on earth. Today, we are witnesses of change.
Thanks for your us pray. O God, whose Son today ascended to the heavens, as the apostles looked on, grant, we pray, that in accordance with his promise, we may be worthy for him to live with us always on earth, and we with him in heaven, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, I pray that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation as you come to know him, so that with the eyes of your heart enlightened, you may know what is the hope to which he has called you, what are the riches of his glorious inheritance among the saints, and what is the immeasurable greatness of his power for us who believe, according to the working of his great power. God put this power to work in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him at his right hand in the heavenly places, far above all rule and authority and power and dominion, and above every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the age to come. And he has put all things under his feet, has made him the head over all things for the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills all in all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. and with your spirit.
Written from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus appeared to the 11 and he said to them, "Go into the whole world and proclaim the good news to the whole creation. The one who believes and is baptized will be saved, but the one who does not believe will be condemned. And these signs will accompany those who believe. By using my name, they will cast out demons. They will speak in a new tongues. They will pick up snakes in her hands. And if they drink any deadly thing, it will not hurt them. They will lay their hands on the sick, and they will recover." So then the Lord Jesus, after he had spoken to them, was taken up into heaven and sat down on the right hand of God. And they went out and proclaimed the good news everywhere, while the Lord worked with them and confirmed the message by the signs that accompanied it. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today Jesus was lifted up to heaven to sit at the right hand of the Father. Imagine the anxious angels approaching Jesus and asking him, "Lord, you have returned to heaven, but what will happen to the kingdom of God on earth? What will be its fate?" And imagine Jesus replying to the angels, "I do not know what you mean. I have left my disciples there." But the angels, seeing how weak and irresponsible Jesus' disciples are, refuse to believe in such an imperfect solution and continue, "Lord, you know how weak people are. Do you really not have any other better plan?" To which Jesus says, "No, there is no other plan, and there will no other plan." Of course, such a conversation between Jesus and the angels did not really take place. But it shows us the task that Jesus entrusted to his disciples, to his followers. Today's liturgical readings reminds us that we, as disciples of Christ, are supposed to continue to build the kingdom and be witness of Jesus. In the first reading we hear, "But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, throughout Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth." Jesus also says similar words in today's Gospel. Today is the solemnity of the ascension of the Lord. In other words, we celebrate Jesus' return to the Father's house. But does this mean that today we celebrate the end of Jesus' presence here on the earth? No. This is not the end of Jesus' presence on earth. Today we are witnessing of change. Jesus, at the time of his ascension, ceased to be present on earth in his human body. From that moment on, Jesus is instead present on earth through his mystical body, the Church, that is, through each one of us. The fact that Christ lives and continues to work in his Church is mentioned in many places in the Scriptures. It is we, Christians, who are the body in which Jesus lives. It is no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me, says the Paul. We Christians are the mind through which Jesus now thinks. May this make you happy, as it was also in Jesus Christ. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Jesus Christ. We are the voice through which Jesus speaks to our contemporaries. Whoever listened to you, listen to me. And whoever rejects you, rejects me. Finally, we are the heart through Jesus, through which Jesus shows his love. Whatever you did from one of the least of these brothers of mine, you did it for me. Jesus was only on earth for 33 years. Jesus was limited by time and place. For this reason, today Jesus wants each one of us, by his own measure, to be his continuation. Through each one of us, Jesus wants to continue his incarnation, death, resurrection, and salvation. Jesus, through us, wants to continue to pray and teach, to suffer and to work. In order to be witnesses of Christ, we do not have to join missions or give homilies or sermons. An example of our life is more eloquent than a homily, and kindness, love, joy, and forgiveness give more happiness than words. So often next to us, in our families, in the neighborhood, in the workplace, there are people who knew so little about Jesus and therefore know him so poorly. Maybe there are our own children, spouses, neighbors, colleagues from the office. However, as we help them to be closer to Christ, let us remember that it is not enough to proclaim his teaching only by the words. We also have to live his teaching and confirm it with our life. Thus, let us always strive to do everything we do as Jesus would have done had he been on earth in that time and that moment. A much more difficult way of witnessing about Christ is to endure suffering and difficulties for him and in the name of his gospel. This happens when we deny ourselves, and regardless of various suffering, persecutions, and difficulties, we believe in the words of Jesus. Blessed are you when people insult you, persecute you, and falsely say all kinds of evil against you because of me. Rejoice and be glad, because great is your reward in heaven. Today, on the day of the Ascension, Jesus invites us to heaven. Where is our home? Where our Father is waiting for us. Our brother Jesus is waiting for us there. Our Mother Mary is waiting for us there. And we will go where when, here on earth, through our lives, through our witnesses, we will build the kingdom of God. I believe in God, the Father Almighty,
Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He was raised from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, our Father, our Father, our Father. From there, we will acknowledge the others who are here and there. Holy and Holy Spirit, the Holy God of the Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Let us pray.
For the Church, that as a people we may renew our sense of mission, fearlessly proclaiming the kingdom of God to the world, we pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our world, that governments will cease the persecution of those least able to defend themselves, the poor, the sick, the elderly, and the unborn. We pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who suffer, that they may know the holiness and the importance of their witness of faith to the people of God. We pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our parish, especially for all of our mothers, that each of us will be God's instrument of compassion, charity, healing each day to others. We pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who have died, that they will be numbered among the blessed, enjoying the glory of God. We pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Almighty Father, hear our prayers for Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Of your glory, as they acclaim. may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Hector, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. The body of Christ.
Amen.
Thank you.
usual prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though you have already come, I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Now never permit me to be separate from you. Amen. Let us pray. May the gifts we have received from your altar, Lord, kindle our hearts and longing for the heavenly homeland and cause us to press forward, following in the Savior's footsteps to the place where for our sake he entered before us, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thank you, God.
Please be seated for a moment.
Hi, good afternoon. My name is Susan, and I'm part of the volunteers for the fundraising for the NEP team. So today, we have a bake sale going on downstairs. So we invite each and every one of you to support us so that we can raise funds for our youth. You're all welcome to pass this way. Thank you.
I wish you a beautiful Saturday, of course. Good coffee with cake. You must eat at home.